Welcome F1 fans, it's Friday morning here in Belgium and hopefully we'll be seeing some on-track action soon as the teams prepare for today's practice session. Spa is such a wonderful track and it's a circuit that the drivers love to race on. But it's also quite challenging, so we should expect to see a number of cars struggle to get up to speed here today.
Yes, there are many aspects to Spa that keep the drivers and teams thinking.
I didn't see either. Weather. Here we are for round 11 in Spa. Just coming off that terrible Hockenheim crash. Let's hope this goes better. I mean, I know all these crashes are my fault. So maybe I should have allowed myself rewinds for this first season. But I don't know. I just feel like it's a little cheap. Even though I have assists on. Yeah, who cares? But I'm gonna continue to keep it off. Start the season or end the season how I started. Let's go on track. Let's keep everything standard. Man, that last thing that happened at Hockenheim was just... super unfortunate. It would have been like a half spin, and I let off the throttle pretty much immediately, and I couldn't, the car wouldn't turn in time for me to get back, so... maybe I'm supposed to keep on the gas when that happens? I don't know. I really don't. Like, I let off the gas and get back on it. Try to do another half spin. I don't know. About the worst place I could be. Let's give ourselves some space here. Didn't mean to break there. Just got scared, I guess. This is a corner I'm pretty bad at. I've heard you don't have to brake there, but I've never successfully taken that corner without braking. That was. Must have hit a sausage curb. Broke. Not good there. Okay. Much better than the first time. I think the AI might make the codemaster, the programmers might make the AI a little bit slower through certain of the high profile tracks, just because they know people would like to win there. I don't know if that's true or not, but it just kind of feels like it to me. Canada, Silverstone and Spa, Monza. What's going on there? Oh, they were in the... Alright, that's good enough for me. It's probably one of the tracks I've driven the most. Didn't have too much of a problem with traction there. I don't think I had oversteered. Coming out of the bus stop chicane. I think that's it though.
End of practice, and it's Lewis Hamilton who was able to achieve the fastest time on the track.
Super Signs is not doing good, buddy.
It's qualifying time at Spa, one of the mightiest tracks on the Formula One calendar. Long straights, up and downhill, Eau Rouge as well.
Can't change my car setup unless I have one loaded. That's weird. Damn it. When I see that DRS light looks solid. I think closed because it's solid. You know what I mean? If that makes sense. Lose a lot of time in this corner. Probably because I brake. I've just never been able to get the angle right to not brake there. And then the bus stop is where I lose probably most of my time. Thank you. Holy shit. Guys, that's my first pole position of the season. Let's turn it into something good.
That's the end of qualifying, and it's Max Verstappen who takes the top spot for tomorrow's race.
They've been working so hard as a team, and they've been rewarded. Such a great performance. And if he drives like that tomorrow, then the race win will definitely be possible.
Wow. Let's not get our hopes up.
Sunday, and that means it's race time here in Spa. As the cars are being prepared, let's join them trackside for the start of the Belgian Grand Prix. On pole position,
so I clearly have the pace here.
Son of Jos Verstappen, who just happened to be one of my
I just need to not make any mistakes. I mean, that's been my problem since the beginning. It's just making mistakes. It's not really my speed. It's consistency. Seems like these AI cars go pretty slow through Eau Rouge as well. I don't think Hamilton is going to take it lying down. I do like that in F1 2014, the AI had a tendency to go incredibly slow on the first lap, and that does not seem to be the case in this game. I almost said screw it, let's try not to brake there, but during a race when you're in front, probably not the best idea to be trying new things. Damn it. Braked it a decent enough time, it's just... I need to look at for the oversteer there, obviously. Because if I go into that wall, bye-bye. Not only the podium. Fuck off, Rosberg. No. Damn it! Fuck. They boxed me in there. I knew I would be able to outbreak them. God, you son of a fuck, man. Well, that didn't take long. Maybe I can take Vettel on the camel straight. Way too late. Man. They just fucking box me in, man. I guess my best bet would have been to just stay in the lane they gave me, but fuck you, we can't go side by side here, Botas. That's not how this works. Looks like Vettel just got by Raikkonen. Shit. No. I hope they keep battling it out. Almost always miss that apex. 2 seconds down on my previous lap. Vettel got passed again. Looks like one of them went off the track there. Thank you. Whoa, okay. That was almost a problem.
Okay, we're ready for you. What was this lap?
Not pitting this lap. Well, I'm glad I knew when to brake there. I still did a little bit late. Hamilton too. Bye-bye. Raikkonen got out in front of... Bottas got out in front of Raikkonen. Go! Jesus, man. He's in third, Vettel.
Just behind you, try to pull the gap.
him at second. Just realized there's never really much of a reason for me to go defensive into corners. Because I can always outbreak them. And if they go on the attack in the inside, I can always try to switch back. Get that angle. Maybe Rosberg can catch up to Vettel and give him some problems so I can catch up. That was amazing that I didn't do any damage or wreck. Or lose any positions. I mean, that was just a miracle of Codemasters. Thank you for your incompetence. I didn't even lose all that much time. I guess 3/4 of a second is a lot for Formula One, but in the grand scheme of things, that could have been a disaster. Just make sure you're here. Yep. That's what I was trying to do when I hit that wall. Whoa. Why am I in third? I mean, I'm not complaining, but... Something happened to... Vettel? Maybe I should pull out of... just to be safe. I don't think I'll run out of fuel even if I keep it on, but... better safe than sorry. Shit. No, fuck you.
You're losing 3 seconds on to Rosberg. 3 seconds.
3 seconds? Holy shit. God! Thanks, I noticed. What the fuck? I'm gonna have to look at that again. Man, I was so excited to get my first podium here. That is incredibly disappointing. I don't even know what to say.
So it's Sebastian Vettel who's brought home the race win today. He mastered the conditions and produced a
Sainz got a point. Verstappen got
Sometimes
a point.
The driver just feels comfortable in the car and he's dialed into the track, making for an unbeatable combination.
Well, what a weekend that has been. Please join us next time for another thrilling installment of this Formula One season.
See when I lose the lead. I forgot what happened. Probably just went wide or something. Oh, there it is. It's just on the camel straight. Yeah, okay, I went wide on. Okay, now what? I'm gonna go towards the end of the race here. I think Monza might be my last opportunity for a podium. Okay, here we go. Bottas creeping up. Side by side there. Cut the corner a little bit. Just ran into him. As always, my fault. I didn't anticipate him I was going too fast through there trying to keep my place. Couldn't turn in enough. Got fucked. Lost my whole wing. That was so close, man. Oh my god. Bottas seems to be good on this, he seems to get better towards the end of the race. So I guess he's managing his tires really well. I don't know. As I said, super disappointing. Could have been an awesome race. But, as always, I fucked up, and, it is what it is. I need to quit saying that. I hate it when people say that. Monza is next. See you next time. Bye-bye.